In this video, we are going to create our first visualization in Qlik Cloud. The purpose of this video is to recreate this dashboard, starting by using the standard options and then switching to customize the created visualization with advanced options. First, create a new sheet in our app. This will open the new standard options. The first visualization that we want to create is a sales per region donut chart. First, drag the sales field to the chart and add it as a measure. Then add region as a dimension. The suggested result is a table, so select a donut chart from the visualization panel. In presentation, you can customize some basic settings. In this case, select labels and then add the title sales per region. Then add another visualization to the sheet. We want to create the total sales and margin KPI chart. First, add sales as a measure. This will automatically create our KPI chart. Then add margin as a second measure. Then in presentation, select label and in the title field type, total sales and margin. The third visualization we want to create is the profit margin gauge chart. This time, we are going to add an expression to calculate the profit margin. The fourth visualization we want to create is the top five customers bar chart. Add customer as the dimension, and then add sales as a measure. The result is a bar chart that we're going to customize later in the advanced options. The fifth visualization we want to create is the quarterly trend line chart. In the standard option, add a visualization and then add the dimension quarter and year. Add sales as a measure. In visualization, pick the line chart to convert the auto-generated table into a line chart. The last visualization we want to create here is the sales trend combo chart. Add a new visualization and then add sales and margin as measures. Then add month-year as a dimension. Then select the combo chart as a visualization. Now that all the visualizations have been created, we can switch to the advanced options to customize them the way we prefer. First, we want to change the color of the donut chart. Select it, and under Color and Legend, disable the auto colors. Select to color it by measure by selecting the option from the drop-down menu. Toggle off the Show Legend option. Next, select the total sales and margin KPI chart. First, label sales the first measure and margin the second one. Then turn off the chart suggestions option. Under Appearance, select Color and turn off the conditional colors and the library colors for the first measure. Then select Red from the color palette. Select the second measure and turn off the library colors option. Then select the green color from the color palette. Next, select the gauge chart and toggle off the chart suggestions. Under presentation, in the range limits, set the min value to -0.5 and the max value to 0.5. Then select the bar option. Toggle on the use segments option and toggle off the use library option. Add a limit by clicking on the button and typing 0.12 in the field. Select red for the values below the limit and green for the values above the limit. Next, select data, and in the number format, select number from the drop-down menu, and then select the percentage option. Select the measure axis, and in the label and title drop-down menu, select labels only. Then select the bar chart and toggle off the chart suggestions. In presentation, select the horizontal mode. Then select data and select the customer dimension. In the limitation drop-down menu, select fixed number and then enter 5 in the expression field, so the visualization will show only the top 5 customers. Then uncheck the show other checkbox. Finally, add the title top 5 customers. Now select the line chart and in appearance, check the show data points checkbox. Then add the title quarterly trend. Then select the combo chart and in colors and legend, toggle off the show legend option. Then in the x-axis, toggle off the continuous scale and uncheck the use continuous scale checkbox. Finally, add the filter panes. In the first one, add year, quarter, month, and week. And then, in the second one, add region. Finally, adjust the positioning of the visualizations in your sheet. And here you have the final result. We have now created our first dashboard in Qlik Cloud. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.